Okay guys, so if you're obviously considering, or you are here, okay guys, so you are clearly here. If you are considering to buy coilovers, or you already do have coilovers installed in your car, are coilovers worth it? Yes and no. I think it's really based on the person, what you would prefer. Before, like, if I saw a car coming the road and it had that stiff, nice, nasty bounce on it, it looks real good online. And since I was like a pygmy, I always wanted that. So I went out and I got myself some coilovers. Drive, in terms of drive, that's a very nice drive. But when you're dialing it and do about 120k's a day, 100k's, 120k's a day, yeah, it takes the fun out of it. I mean, if this car only drove to the track or wherever on a weekend or whatever, then it would be so lekker. Then I would definitely recommend it to anyone. I still do recommend coilovers. Also, based on the brand you buy, obviously from my knowledge, BC being the best, you probably get the best ride out of those coilovers. Also, what the guys do to get more lows, or they remove the helpers, which I had in my car, I had no helpers in my car. So it obviously had a bit of a harder ride. Put it into perspective, you are gonna have to sacrifice your comfort to look good on the road. And that's not for everyone. So it's really a choice that you're gonna have to make. There's lots of things that you can do to make the drive better. From what I know is you can do C-notch. Some people say that extend the top mount drive better as well on coilovers. So there's lots of things you can do. But for me personally, I think I had my time with coilovers, so I'm actually going back to stock suspension. I bought four Monroes right around, and I'm gonna go a lowering kit. Here's a 60 mil kit that I'll be fitting in. I was looking at the shortened shock for the front, just so you can get the best out of the shock still, so you can still have the suspension travel. But it was a bit pricey though. Like, they charged me 1.3 each for the front, so that it becomes like 2.6 just for the two front shocks, which was a bit out of my budget. Instead I just went the standard size shock. It should still give me a good drive, because I mean it's still brand new. So yeah, it's still a brand new shock, another thing. I just missed the comfortability of like a normal OEM feel. Like, I would get into my friend's car that like it's not lowered and stuff like that, and it's just comfortable. So like, some of you will say, yeah, it's the life and it comes with a bit, well, yeah, right enough, it is the life. But I've obviously experienced it for myself now, so I know what I like and what I don't like. But mainly the thing that put the last nail in the coffin for me was just the comfort. And I really miss that, so that's why I'm going back to the standard suspension, just to get a better drive out of it, as I do use it daily. And yeah, just for more comfort. But that's me personally, I can't speak for the next person. So is it worth it? Yes, it is. Definitely is. All depending on what you want out of the car. So, if it's a purpose built for racing, then by all means, even if it's your daily, like, you know you're gonna fit coilovers, so you're gonna have to accept the fact that you're gonna compromise a bit on the comfortable side, on the comfortability of your ride. So it's a personal thing, man. And for those that don't have coilovers in yet, go buy a new set of coilovers. Goodbye, Mr. Coilovers. And just keep the helpers in. If you want a comfortable drive, keep the helpers in. And maybe just do extended top mounts to get more lows, because the guys usually remove the helpers so they can get more lows. Whereas you can rather just do extended top mounts and keep the helpers in, because the helpers makes a huge difference in your inner drive. And also, no, Monster didn't sponsor this video, but if Monster executives are watching this, please hit your boy up on Instagram. And I slap a saying for you guys also that's watching, if you are not Follow me on Insta. Please go follow me on Insta. I'd appreciate it. It's at RiceLifeSA or at RiceLife_SA. So yeah, it's basically a personal choice. So yeah, for me personally, I just didn't like the fact that I had to compromise my comfortability or my ride for it. So I'm going back to full Monroe's, actually in the car already. Having full Monroe cash riders and a 60 mil kit right around. Now I wasn't over the 60-40 when I thought, ah, let me just see what the 60 right around looks. And I'm still busy putting in the rears now with the fronts in. And it sits pretty well. It sits pretty nicely. I'm happy with it. But yeah, I should get like the best drive out of it now because I have brand new shocks as well. So yeah, we'll see. But yeah, that's the end of the video. To come to conclusion, all based on your preference. If you know what you're buying, so you're gonna have to, it comes with its pros and cons. Comfortability being one thing that you're gonna have to be losing. In terms of the ride, I had John Blue lines in. There's obviously other brands. There's Ned Nevos. There's BC. There's Blue Line, Red Line, John. So I don't know. And some of the more expensive or upmarket coilovers also have dampening settings. So yeah, there's lots of things you can do, man. So yeah, that's all basically based on preference. But for me, put the last nail in the coffin was the comfortability. And so I'm going back to a standard way of life just with a kit in. Hopefully I get the best drive, and hopefully it's much more comfortable. Yeah, I will add some cinematics in. Thank you.